Hello, I'm Jidada, I'm a DJ and music producer from Berlin, and in this video I'm going to create a track from scratch by being creative with 5 samples. I'm going to use several methods how you can or could use samples in Ableton Live 10, and after this I'm going to show you how I have created and recorded the track. As you can see now, I have opened an Ableton session. Let's look on the right side. First, I'm going to show you all the samples I have used for this track. Let's listen to the 5 samples I have picked.
Take it back.
Let's see what we can do with the samples and if we can create some elements for a track. On the left side, I have created a basic drum rack. I've also used a tambourine sample to extract a MIDI clip. And this time I've chosen another option. There is also the function convert drums to MIDI track. Ableton has created a new MIDI clip. As you can see here, it has created a closed hi-hat here. First of all, this hi-hat was a little bit too long. I wanted to sound it sharper. That's why I faded out the sample and adjusted the marker here. I've also EQ'd the hi-hat. Because some of the high frequencies were disturbing, I've used the de-esser here. I've also used a vocoder to change the sound of the hi-hats. Now I'm going to show you what is the difference. This is with effects. Now I'm going to put off the effects. Now I'm showing you how I've recorded the drums. Now I'm going to show you how I made the bass. Here is the bass and it sounds like this. This bass is based on the bass sample I've showed you before. Let's see how it sounds again. And now I'm going to show you how I've used this bass sample to create my own bassline and being creative with it. I have right-clicked on the mouse and have chosen Convert melody to another MIDI track. I'm clicking on this, and what Ableton does, it creates a new MIDI track with a new instrument rack inside. Now we can listen to this bass and see how it sounds. It sounds already quite okay, but it's not the bass I want to use for this track. So now I'm showing you how I've changed the bass line initially, just having the inspiration of the sample. I've changed the rhythm and also the melody of the bass line, so it fits to my drum groove. I've also changed the device. Let's watch how I have recorded and changed the bass line.
I'm going to use my Ableton Push now to change this melody of the bass.
And now we are going to dive into the details of what I've done. I've just picked this MIDI track and deleted this device that Ableton has created. I've picked another bass, in this case it was the analog 80s bass, and I've created a whole instrument rack with several effects. So how do we do it? We go to our MIDI track. Then we choose analog bass. We add this to our MIDI track. Then we are grouping this device to create a whole instrument rack. We do this by pressing Ctrl G. I'm going to dive into the ready instrument rack now to show you what kind of parameters I've changed and how I've built the effect chain. I've just clicked on the amp 1 and have looked what are the parameters. I've changed the release to 160 milliseconds, before it was much longer. I've also changed the sustain to 0.79. Just use your ears while listening to the bass and set all the parameters how you want to have it. It's just about experimenting with all the parameters here. Let's look into other settings I've changed. As you can see, I've also picked two other samples. In this case, for example, the female vocal. I've noticed that the female vocal is not perfectly harmonizing with the bass I've picked. So what I have done is, I've just detuned the bass a little bit. I've used both oscillators here and I've detuned the oscillator 2 a bit and also the oscillator 1. Now let's look in the effect chain to make the bass sound a little bit warmer and more present. I've used a saturator. I've also used a compressor, a simple chorus, and to give the bass a little bit more character, I've also used a filter. Now let's look inside the female vocal. When we double click on the sample, we can see the section here. When I played the vocals with the bass, I've noticed that it's not fitting to the bass. I've showed you before that I also changed some parameters in the bass and had to detune it a little bit so it harmonizes with this vocal.
But I also had to change the female vocal a little bit. As you can see, you have also transpose and detune options here on the left side. So what I've done is, I've just transposed the female vocal to -1 and detuned it a little bit so it harmonizes with the bass. In the next step, I'm going to show you how I've recorded a pad melody, and after this I'm going to explain how I've created the pad sound with the sample I've chosen here. So now let's look into the sample and listen to it again. So let's watch the recording video.
Oh no!
going to show you how I've built this pad sound. I'm creating again a MIDI track. Then I'm going to the instrument section and pick the sampler. Now I can click on my sample and drag and drop it into the sampler. Now the sampler shows you the sample. When you click on the zone, you can layer different samples even, if you want to. You could also just pick some other samples and drag and drop it here. So you can create different polyphonic harmonies. But for now, I'm going to show you how to do it with one sample. Let's delete this again and look on our sample here. I'm going to zoom in and see how the waveform looks like. As you can see, the volume of the sample is very low. And here it's also decreasing. So let's search for a position in the sample where we could make a good pad sound. We also have to pay attention where another tone is played in the sample. It depends on what we want to do. For now, I just want to pick one tone. Let's see how this sounds now. Okay, as you can hear, the tones are sounding very short. So, what do we have to do now if you want a pad sound that sounds really spheric and nice? We need to change some parameters in the device. So let's look inside the device. Underneath here you have this section. You have different possibilities to choose between different sustain modes. And also, you can choose between different release modes. Let's see what I've done exactly. Just look at this device for now. I'm going to zoom into the sample and show you what I've done. As you can see, you have two types of markers here.
The one below is to pick the part of the sample that you want to use. The markers above are defining the area where you want to fade the sample in and out. You can move around those markers and play around with it and create interesting sound textures choosing different parts of the sample. As you can see, I've chosen this sustain mode here. What does this sustain mode do? It is playing the sample forth and back.
As you can see, I've faded out the sample like this. I've also detuned the sample a little bit so it sounds nice and harmonizing with the bass and the female vocal. Of course, you need to listen to everything together to hear if it's harmonizing or not. Now let's look into the other sections of this device and see what I've changed also. Let's click on the filter and global section. So, as you can see, I've picked a low pass filter. Well, to make the pad sound a little bit more moving and spacey, I've added a dirty tremolo and some kind of echo that makes this sound less dry.